वक्रतुंड महाकाया सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। नमस्ते। वेलकम टू द सेकंड सेशन ऑफ गीता जयंती सेलिब्रेशन। आवर टीचिंग टीम लेड बाय डॉक्टर तिम्मा हेगड़े सर हैव अ फ्यू मोर श्लोकास फ्रॉम सेकंड एंड थर्ड चैप्टर्स फॉर अवर स्टडी टुडे। श्रीमती मीनाक्षी एंड श्रीमती श्यामला विल चैंट श्लोकास 54 टू 72 ऑफ चैप्टर 2 एट द एंड ऑफ अवर सेशन। दीज श्लोकास डिस्क्राइब द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड परफेक्ट पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ स्थित प्रज्ञा। नाउ लेट अस गेट ऑन विथ अवर क्लास। हेगड़े सर।
गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरु। अब गीता जयंती सेलिब्रेशन is offering our reverence and gratefulness to the Jagat Guru, Shri Krishna, for having given us the Bhagavad Gita, which has a potential to transform our lives. The session today that we are looking is how we can transform work into worship. It is all about Karma Yoga. Shri Krishna, in the fifth verse of the third chapter, has said that it is not possible to be without action even for a second. Nahi kaschit kshanamam api. Even for a second, human beings cannot be without any form of action. And therefore, all the time, either we are thinking or we are speaking or we are doing something or the other. So this aspect of Karma Yoga is how we can transform every action that we do into a form of worship. Karma Yoga is primarily dealt with in chapters 2, 3, 4, and 5, although it is there in almost all chapters of the Bhagavad Gita, particularly again in the 18th chapter where Krishna summarizes all the verses. We will now look at what is the big difference between a Karma Yogi and a Karmi. A Karmi is a person who works or even works hard. And a lot of people who work hard think they are Karma Yogis. Now we will have a clear distinction between what Swamiji calls a person who works very hard and what really is a Karma Yoga. When does work become a sadhana? When does work become worship? It is only after we come into the study of Vedanta, we see so much of the disadvantages of work. The disadvantage of any action is any action that you do generates a phalam, a consequence. And the consequence can be for a good action, you have punya, for a bad action, you have papa. And whether it is punya or papa, it causes a certain bondage. There is a certain account in our karmic account which we have to utilize it at some stage, if not in this life, at some other life. The big transition is Karma Yoga paves for liberation. How this happens is the theme of this particular chapter. When we studied Upadeshasara, we realized all these disadvantages of karma, and Bhagavan Ramana begins by hitting hard on karma. And his words are, Kartrur Ajaya Praptaye Param, Karma Kim Param. That means don't think karma is great. Param means great. Karma is not the highest. And he uses another harsh word, Karma Tat Jadam. Karma is inert in itself. And then the next word, he gives more problems about karma. He says, Kriti Mahodadav. Kriti means karma is like an ocean. That means the more successful that you are in your work enhances or increases in geometric progression. Patana Karanam, it can be the cause of your downfall. Palama Sashvatam, whatever benefit you get from karma is asashvata. It is not permanent. and gati nirodhaka. It is an obstacle to spiritual growth. All of us are here for one purpose only. We are here to attain to Parama Purusharta or Moksha. But what is our experience? We experience limitation all the time. And in Sanskrit, limitation is called bandha. And because we experience limitations and we don't want limitations, most of our life's activities are struggle to overcome these limitations. We want to be in charge of our lives. Many things that we don't want to happen keep happening. And many things that we want to happen do not happen. This puts us into what is called the cycle called samsara. And Swamiji has used the word called MBBS. Most of our lives are so repetitive. And when lives become so repetitive, our lives become MBBS. That means it becomes meaningless, boring, burdensome struggle. And the word he uses is a sorry go-round. Just like the London Eye, which never stops, our the cycle of life continues to go, as Adi Shankara has so nicely, this popular verse in the Bhaja Govindam, which says, Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Janani, Jatare Shayanam, Iha Samsare, Bahudustare, Kripaya Pare, Pahi Murare. O Lord, O Krishna, please see that somehow I'm able to get out of this repetitive cycle of MBBS. Remember, action is of three types. It can be done through the body when it is called kaya. It can be action through speech. It is called vacha. Or it can be mental, which is called manasa. Now, we will be looking at some of the superlatively best verses of the Bhagavad Gita, which will help us to see how every action that we do, from the time we wake up till the time we sleep, we have all those hours and all those moments to be able to transform our work to worship. The opening verse is a very popular verse, and that will be explained to us by Vinayakan. Over to you, Vinayakan, please.
Sri Gurubhyo Namah. Second chapter, 47th verse, goes like this. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phalahe durbhuhu ma te sangostva karmani. Lord Krishna says, you have a choice over action alone, never over the results. May you not be motivated by the results of actions. May you not have an inclination towards inaction. This is an important verse of Bhagavad Gita, which gives the principles and wisdom of Karma Yoga. What attitude or what understanding a Karma Yogi has with regard to action and results? In Karma Yoga, most important two things are karma and karma phala. I should have a healthy attitude towards both karma and karma phala to be a Karma Yogi. If I should have a healthy attitude, I should have a proper understanding of both, because attitude depends upon my understanding. Swamiji says, without a cognitive change, an attitudinal change is impossible. And in life, what primarily matters is attitudinal change. And for the attitudinal change, the foundation is cognitive change. And by cognitive change, what we mean is a change in our understanding of the thing. Lord Krishna says, Te karmani adhigara asti. Certainly, you have a choice with regard to action that you want to do. And Lord Krishna says, Faleshu kadachana. With regard to karma phalam, you do not have a choice. Therefore, you should know what is with choice and what is without choice. In a nutshell, karma vishaye adhigara asti, karma phala vishaye adhigara nasti. Use the fullest choice before you take any course of action. But at the same time, be intelligent enough and strong enough to accept the results. Lord Krishna says, do not stop actions. At the same time, do not expect that whatever result you want, that will alone will come. Do not do the actions. It is very important. What we prepare for any type of result, which is not determined not by you alone, but determined by so many other factors. Therefore, this mental preparedness to receive any result is intelligent attitude. In the second line, Lord says, Akarmani Sangama, at the same time, do not think that your actions are waste. Even though single contribution does not determine the totality, single contribution is not waste. Therefore, while doing the actions, mentally tell, oh Lord, give me the strength to accept the consequence gracefully. And last, in second line, Lord says, Ma karma, karma phala hetur bhogu. This is another important aspect of Karma Yoga. May the motives not be heavily on external accomplishment. While working in this world, let not focus be on the money, status, fame or gain, which is unpredictable. Otherwise, only when the material gain is there, we are at the top of the world. Life will be then full of ups and downs. Don't make the fulfillment depend on that. The focus should be on very action, the experience we gain from it. Lord Krishna says, Arjuna, we are Arjuna here. Serve the society in whatever way you can. Do not run away from your responsibilities. Focus on inner growth, not on only on external growth. Hari Om. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinayakan, for covering this very popular verse, Karmanyavadikaraste Ma Phaleshu Kadachana. You touched on every aspect of it. The focus here is, I have the freedom, I have the choice on my actions, but not on the results. So can I have prasada buddhi? That shall I be able to accept whatever I get as a consequence of my action as a prasada very cheerfully? And in case it doesn't come towards the way I expected, let me see how I can learn from my actions. In that way, every action can be a learning experience. So well said that when you win, you win. When you lose, you learn, and therefore you win. So you can be a winner always when you have an attitude of a karma yogi. Krishna is very much against akarmani. That means, because of the fear of the consequence of action, he says, never refrain from inaction. Here, inaction means not doing something. Krishna always wants us to be very active. Yeah, so this is one of the advice. These are the two important points of this very popular verse. I spoke about Upadesha Sara of Bhagwan Ramana. After giving the two verses where he has hammered out all the disadvantages about karma, he has given in one line which beautifully summarizes the entire karma yoga. What is karma yoga? He says, Ishwar Arpitam. Whatever action you do it as an offering to someone you love, as an offering to God. Na Ichchaya Kritam. Don't bring your decision on what the fruit of your actions should be. What was just now explained, chitta shodaka. It purifies my mind. It gives me jnana yogyata and mukti sadakam. It paves the way to freedom. So the karma can become karma, which is normally a binding karma, now can become a liberating karma. Dr. Sundar has another beautiful verse to explain. Over to you, Dr. Sundar.
Hari Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Yogastha kuru karmani sangam tvekta dananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate. So this verse defines karma yoga by the word samatvam. In the first line, Lord Krishna addresses Arjuna as well as us sadhakas, kuru karmani, do actions, yogastha, by following the principles of karma yoga. So this he defines in the second and the third line, sangam tvekta dananjaya. Here he is telling, don't take to the wrong attitude of being attached to the action. Siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva. Here Lord Krishna is telling, don't take to the wrong attitude of being attached to the results. This together he is defining as samatvam. Yoga uchyate, karma yoga is samatvam. With such emphasis on the word samatvam, let's try to understand what is samatvam in the next slide. Samatvam, also called as equanimity or equipoise, is that balanced state of mind which allows me externally to take to selfless action, which is also called as satkarma, satvikarma, karma, nishkama karma. Samatvam is that balanced attitude which allows me internally to develop an attitude which is called as the right attitude, sadbhavana, which is one of Ishvara Prasada Bhava and Ishvara Arpana Buddhi, which we shall see in detail in further slides. And all this is happening in a milieu of good values, which is called Sadguna. As we see here, Sadbhavana and Sadguna are invisible attitudinal attributes. We have to be always alert what action seems to be helping a large number of people may not qualify to be a karma yoga because it may not have these attributes of sadbhavana and sadguna associated to them. Since karma yoga is more at the level of buddhi, more to do with attitude, let us now look into the details. What is the right attitude? In the next slide, right action is defined as that which is beneficial to large number of people, also described as Panchamahayajna, also described as dharma, where there is more of giving than taking. Now in the next slide, let us see what is right attitude. Right attitude can be divided into right attitude towards the act and right attitude towards the result. So Lord Krishna said, don't be attached to the act. So what it means is, I look at my life, I feel blessed that Lord has given me tremendously. And now out of gratitude, can I look at every moment of the day, every act that I do as an act of gratitude, humbly submitted at his lotus feet? This attitude of gratitude, or being an instrument in the hands of God, is called Ishvara Arpana Bhava. How does this give us samatvam? Whatever act I may be doing, my primary focus is on keeping an attitude where I'm offering it to the Lord's feet out of gratitude. The act itself is secondary to me. So it may be something as simple as wiping a desk or as complicated as doing a surgery. However, the attitude of offering is important, not the act itself. Because of this, I start looking at all acts equally. I start doing all acts wholeheartedly with a smile on face without boredom of repetitiveness. Thereby, this brings about samatva. Now let us look at the right attitude towards the result. Result can be seen as drishtaphalam, which is in the terms of material success or failure, or adrishtaphalam in the form of punyam, in the form of chitta shuddhi or inner growth, which Lord Krishna promises us as long as we do karma as karma yoga. Now I focus on this inner growth as the primary result which accrues to me. I look at the material result which accrues as being subservient, as being secondary, of a lesser importance to me. Now this automatically brings about samatvam because my focus is on inner growth which is assured to me. Therefore, even if the material result is a failure, I view upon it as a success. Thereby, this right attitude to result brings about samatvam. Now we all know that karma yoga gives us viveka vairagya tivra mumukshutvam. Let us try to understand how this is possible. We have seen that these two right attitudes bring us samatvam. This samatvam, which is a calm state of mind, affords me to sit back and look at the experiences of my life. And then I see that all the worldly accomplishments that I have got do not give me lasting happiness, peace, and security. Then I question, is there another goal which is worth pursuing, which can give me that everlasting happiness, peace, and security? This discrimination is viveka. This then causes vairagyam or dispassion to that entire worldly accomplishments, which fail to give me lasting happiness, peace, and security, and allows me to turn the focus towards God, which is tivra mumukshutvam. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Sundar. To me, this is real celebration of Gita Jayanti. When you take each verse, yogastaha kuru karmani sangam tyaktva dananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate. Now, these are verses which have been given to the Lord, by the Lord, to meditate, to let it saturate into our bodies and to see how it comes out into action. Very nicely explained, because essentially our actions, one of the definitions brought out in this action is, through action, let me understand what is samatvam. My mind should never be perturbed when I am in action. And that is one of the definition or the hallmark of a karma yogi. One beautiful example given to us by Swami Anubhavananda is about traveling on a railway compartment on an RAC ticket. So those who have never traveled RAC, RAC means reservation against cancellation. Very often it used to happen that when you travel, because the tickets are always overbooked, the ticket you have is a narrow berth seat, not one of those long ones that you see. And if there are too many passengers, it is possible that you don't get a berth, but you get a seat to travel. But it is possible, because if there is cancellation, you may get a berth and you may have a more comfortable travel, which means when the journey starts, you are unsure whether you're going to get a berth or not. Now, there are two categories of people in the same area, one who have a confirmed seat and another person who is not sure if he's going to get a berth or not. When you are not too sure, just see the attitude that these two categories of people have when the ticket collector comes. You will see, whenever it is your need, whenever it is my need, you will see sometimes even people in authority, one of the biggest bosses of your organization, whenever they have a need, you will see how nice they can be. And whenever it is my need and I need a berth, when the ticket examiner comes, I am all smiles, hoping that he will be nice to me. Why is this important? Whenever we are doing any form of karma, especially for those who may be in a position of authority and sometimes feel that they are doing others a favor, or those who are high skilled, who are sought out by a large number of people, remember that it is the patient who creates the doctor. Because we are all mutually dependent. And the more you realize that it is because of the patient, my existence is there. And if I am able to see that he creates me professionally, wherever there is a sense of it is my need, you are naturally nice. Whenever you are a little arrogant, remember this example, and that will make you suddenly much more gentle and a much more nicer person. We have another beautiful verse by which will be explained to you by Dr. Anupama. Dr. Anupama, please.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, chapter 2, verse 50. Buddhi yukto jahatita ubhe sukruta duskrute tasmat yogaya yujasva yogaha karmasu kaushalam. In this verse, the phalam of karma yoga is revealed. We have to focus on three key words here. First, buddhi yukta, kaushalam, and finally, iha. What is karma yoga? Proper action performed with proper attitude is karma yoga. Proper action is performance of swadharma. Proper attitude is Ishvara Arpana Bhava, that is, performance of duty without ego or ahankara. This is called a kartatvam. A combination of this attitude with the acceptance of results of actions as the will of God is called prasada buddhi, a bhoktatvam. Next, samatva bhava is also called buddhi yoga. Kaushalam is skill in action. A mental state of equanimity or poise, resulting in freedom from anxiety regarding consequences of actions, is called samatvam. Kaushalam is an attitudinal change which enables the karma yogi to convert binding actions into liberating ones. Now, what is the difference between a karma yogi and a karmi? A karmi is engrossed in performing kamya karmas to generate punyas and prayaschita karmas to remove papas. This incessant activity only fuels the cycle of rebirth. A karma yogi, on the other hand, who's called a buddhi yukta here, is endowed with samatvam and kaushalam. He effortlessly renounces, or called jahati, ubhe, both punya karmas, sukritam, and papam, called dushkritam. What is the reward of karma yoga? Every karma has an inherent binding nature which generates punyam and papam. This perpetuates the cycle of janana and marana, birth and death. A karma yogi parityajyati, or jahati, that is, totally renounces or overcomes the binding effect of karma. This liberating effect is called inaction in action, or akartatvam. Does a karma yogi attain moksha? We must note that karma yoga will not automatically give jnanam or moksha. If it were to be so, then what about jnanat eva tu kaivalyam, or na karmana na prajaya dhanena, etc.? Therefore, prepare yujasva by practicing karma yoga and attain chitta shuddhi. Chitta shuddhi is the sakshat phalam of karma yoga. Moksha is the parampara phalam attained in due course. Chitta shuddhi leads to guru prapti. Guru prapti leads to shravana, manana, and nidhityasana. This in turn to jnanam, and it is this jnanam which finally results in moksha. Now, when and where is this possible? Lord Krishna says, iha, asmin loke, here and now, in this very janma. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Anupama. Another very beautiful verse during this season of Gita Jayanti to meditate on. Buddhi yukto jaha tiha ube sukrute dushkrute tasmad yogaya yujyasva yogaha karmasu kausalam. Kausalam here means skill, and very nicely explained. Skill is not the skill as a surgeon or a skill in any particular field. The skill is how you can transform binding karma into a liberating karma. In the medical field, like Botox, you will see there are so many uses of poisonous venom, snake venom, which can be used in medicine. Just like that, how you can transform a binding action to a liberating action, very beautifully brought out in this verse. We have three more exceedingly beautiful verses from the third chapter, and these will sequentially tell us more about karma. Over to you, Dr. Kiran.
Thank you, sir. Chapter 3 offers one of the best discourses about karma or action. It starts with Arjuna seeking clarification as to what path to take. Krishna glorifies Jnana Marga, but seemed to be asking Arjuna to fight. Gora Karmani, dreadful deed of killing his own kith and kin. Lord clarifies that both are important. Example, hunger is satiated by eating food, but preparing food is equally important. Man, because of free will bestowed to him, can pursue goals or purushartha. Moksha or enlightenment is the ultimate goal, is a choice he can take. But for his other requirements, he has to do action or karma without choice. Because Lord says, man cannot maintain even his body without action and cannot remain silent even for a moment. Kshana api, he says. As we are listening, we will be shaking our legs or fidgeting. Now let us come to the verse proper. Next slide. Niyatam kuru karma, tvam karma jayaho hi akarmanaha. Sharirayatrapi cha tena prasadayat akarmanaha. perform the obligatory action as explained in Vedas, for action is superior to inaction. From inaction, even the maintenance of the body is not possible. Here, two key words we have to learn. One is niyatam. That means he explains it as a command. Whether you are a brahmachari, gruhastha, or sannyasi, you have to perform action. Till when? Tvam. As long as this ego or doership is there, you have to perform action. This is explanation of karmanye vadhikaraste or kuru karmani mantra in Isha Upanishad. Karma Yoga, having explained futility and, next slide please. Having explained the futility and dangers of avoiding action, Lord Krishna advises one should do action. These are seed verses of Karma Yoga. Lord further explains, now that we know karma is essential, why not use it as a means of attaining the ultimate? Such a deliberate, planned, proper action with proper attitude is Karma Yoga, and it becomes a necessary qualification for obtaining jnana. Karma is divided into sattvika karma, which is uttama, that is, it benefits others more than ourselves and helps in spiritual progress. And rajasika, this is a madhyama type of karma, which is selfish action but doesn't cause harm to others. And tamasic, which causes actions which causes damage to oneself and others, and inhibits spiritual progress. Now that aim of seeker should be sattvika karma. What is sattvika karma and how to do it? It is defined as pancha mahayajna. That is, five mahayajnas we have to do. First is deva yajna, that is serving gods and telling prayers, etc. Next is pitru yajna, that is serving parents and elders. Brahma yajna, serving teacher and their teachings. Manushya yajna, that is serving fellow beings. And bhuta yajna, serving all beings, plants, animals, nature, etc. This he calls as pancha yajna. We have to say yes to whatever life throws at you and thank you to whatever the result be. Our action, life and being should be expression of gratitude to God. This yajna, he says, should be done regularly as agnya or command, as we have not yet understood its importance. Through karma yoga, we can get rid of our impurities and attain chitta shuddhi, which is an important qualification and tool for pursuing jnana yoga to realize the self, the greatest quest of mankind. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Kiran. Niyatam kuru karma. When it is said niyatam, here comes an order from the Lord. And what action to be done? Lord Krishna does not want you to be lazy. He wants you to do action. But then he says prescribed action. This is where we go to the Veda Purva. And the Veda Purva defines exactly what we should do. In the early stages, when a person in the form of an order, there is no choice. And what is among the things that we have to do every day? And this is what has already been explained, whether we should not consider this as a waste of time. When your day starts, begin with Deva Yajna. Spend a dedicated amount of time in your prayer room with some form of a ritualistic prayer, some form of mantras that you can spend some time. Then is some time for our prayer, for our ancestors, service to our parents and for the elders in the community as part of Pancha Mahayajna. An extra mile service to fellow human beings becomes Manushya Yajna, and Bhuta Yajna, service to plants, animals, and the environment. And finally, what we are doing right now, the scriptural studies, the propagation and promotion of all the scriptural work, and also the understanding, the whole Gita Jayanti celebrations is part of all the Brahma Yajna. There are two more verses which very sequentially tell us about karma. The first was karma has to be done as an order. The next verse will be explained to us by Dr. Divakar. Dr. Divakar, please.
Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good evening, everybody. Chapter 3, verse 9. Yagnartat karmanon yatra lokoyam karma bandhanaha tadartam karma kaunteya mukta sangha samachara. Krishna talks about karma yoga from four angles in the chapter 3. Karma as Ishwara Agna, as we saw in the last verse. Karma as Yajna, as Chitta Shodhana, and as Dharma. In the verse 3.8, we saw karma as Ishwara Agna, where an element of fear is induced by Krishna. In this verse, we will see the angle of Yajna, doing the actions as an offering, as worship to the God. Doing any actions fearing God is neither psychologically beneficial, nor it brings the lasting desirous results. Krishna says, while the immature people can continue to do karma out of fear of the God, as it is still better than not doing any work, mature people should do karma as an offering to the God. That is, every action, be it professional, be it personal, be it for the family, be it self-care, should be done as a yajna to the God. Yajnartham karma. This attitude of seeing every work as worship can only come if I realize that my body, my mind, intellect, my family, and in fact, the entire world is a gift given to me by the God through Panchabhutas, so that I can accomplish my Purusharthas, particularly Moksha Purusharthas. With this attitude of gratitude, Krishna says a mature person should do all actions as Ishwara Arpana Bhava without identifying oneself as a doer, without any attachment either to the act or to its results. Mukta Sangaha. This is the key word in this verse. This verse clearly states that Krishna doesn't ask us to stop doing karma, but says the attitude towards our karma should be with devotion, as an offering to the God. Naturally, such a karma yogi with Ishwara Arpana Bhava will also accept any outcomes arising from those actions as Ishwara Prasada Bhava with all humility. Such a nishkama karma, desireless action, doesn't accrue punyam or papam. Then Krishna gives a big warning. Anyatra ayam lokaha karma bandhanaha. Anyatra. Any work, action other than yajnartham karma, that is, any karma without the devotion of offering to the God, will result in bondage and the cycle of sorry go round will continue. Lokaha karma bandhanaha. Let us quickly look at some of the differences between karma and karma yoga. The action without any devotion is karma, but that with devotion of Ishwara Arpana and Prasada attitude is karma yoga. Karma can give material benefits, whereas karma yoga gives both material as well as spiritual benefits. Karmi will consume more from the society than contributing, and only himself, his family, and his close associates will benefit from him. Whereas a karma yogi contributes more to the society than what he consumes, and the majority of people will benefit from him. Karma reinforces doership and receivership and entangles a person in psychological roller coaster all his life. On the other hand, karma yogi doesn't identify with either the doership or receivership, which will help in mind purification and the tranquility. Karmi counts his problems and acts for fulfillment, whereas a karma yogi counts his blessings and acts out of fulfillment. Karma yoga is an essential practical sadhana that we should practice every day for the mind purification in order to progress spiritually. Hari Om, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Devakar, for a nice explanation of how you can make karma as a yajna, as an offering. And you have given us a very brilliant slide for us to study what is the difference between just work, karma, and when does work become worship, when karma becomes a yoga. As explained already, whenever you do an action with devotion, as Ishwara Arpana, it becomes a yajna and that paves for liberation. When action is done mechanically, it produces bondage. There is a beautiful verse from the Viveka Chudamani about the three important blessings. All students of Vedanta and all of us need to be extremely grateful for three things: Manushyutvam, Mumukshutvam, Mahapurusha. all these three blessings have been given to us as a grace of the Lord. So I should be so grateful that I have some of the best things in the world. I have the human birth. I have the burning desire to attain to freedom in this life itself. And I have the grace of the teachings of a guru. And therefore, when I'm so grateful, what do I do with this blessing? Let me see, whatever I do will now become a yajna. All my action now becomes a gift to God as a gratefulness for all that I have received. Mrs. Rama Gopalakrishna will explain another very important aspect of Karma Yoga through verse 13. Rama, please.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Verse 3.13. Yajna Sheshtashina Santo Mochyante Sarva Kilbishaihi Bhunjate Te Twagham Papaha Ye Pachantyatma Karanat. The word meaning Santaha, the noble ones, Yajna Sheshtashinaha, who partake of the sacred remnants of Yajnas, Muchyante, or freed from Sarva Kilbishaihi, from all sins. Two, but Te Papaha, those sinful ones, Ye Pachanti, who cook, Atma Karanat, for their own sake, Bhunjate Agham, take in the sin into them. The summary of the verse, those noble ones who partake of the sacred remnants of Yajnas are freed from all sins, but those ones who cook for their own sake partake of sin. Here, Swami Paramarthananda analyzes Karma Yoga as Dharma Pravartakaha, Chitta Shodhakaha, and Mukti Sadhakaha. Every action has two aspects. They are doership and results of the action. Karma Yoga is converting every activity like walking, cooking, meeting with customers to worship and accept results of every action as Ishvara Prasadam. Prasadam may be divine leftovers, salary, pleasures, success, or even glory. Karma Yogi renounces Kartrutva or doership and accepts the results of actions as Prasadam without any choice. He realizes that the root cause of Papam is delusion and frees himself from them through Prayashchitta Karmas. He continues to do good karmas and enjoy worldly pleasures also. Sri Krishna calls karma yogis as santaha. Sri Shankara Bhasha says, sarva kilbishaihi muchyante te. Here, kilbishaihi means sarva papani, which he terms as panchasunu. They are papams done unknowingly. Karma yogi realizes that whatever obstructs his spiritual growth is papam. The Karma Yogi does Panchamaha Yajnas as Prayashchitta Karmas for those papams. Primarily achieves Chitta Shuddhi, an essential factor for spiritual growth, and makes him fit for Jnana Yoga or Vedanta Shravana. He trains his mind gradually to be emotionally undisturbed. He realizes that only Atma Jnanam can change the attitude towards the world, and he cannot change the world. Attitude to life changes and dispassionately accepts the results, good or bad. In the second half of the shloka, Sri Krishna condemns the selfish people who does kamya karmas for their fulfillment of personal desires. Even though it appears selfish people enjoy worldly pleasures, in their subtler level, they are accumulating papams in different forms. They fall spiritually. They are after kama and karma. Hence, they are caught up in an endless cycle of birth and death. In Vedic times, mode of ritual was yajna for chitta shuddhi. In these times, consider life as a great ritual and convert all activities into worship. Serve the nature and the society with this attitude. In this way, one can convert all actions into spiritual actions, lead a peaceful life, sustaining on whatever be the outcome. Hari Om. Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you very much, Ramaji, for a nice explanation of this particular verse. If you look at the literal translation, it does not make any meaning. But having gone through what Swamiji has to say through Shankara Bhashyam, we say that this particular verse tells us how Karma Yoga can be used. If done properly, it can take all the impurities or the mala that we have in the mind. We are born with those six inner enemies called Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Mada, Matsarya. And therefore, we have it is a hindrance for spiritual progress. When Karma Yoga is done over a period of time, this mala or the impurity of the mind is sequentially worked on. Just like before you paint a wall, you scrub off all that was there before, all our Kama, Krodha has to go. In these three particular verses of the third chapter, we have sequentially seen initially how karma has to be done as an agnya. You have no choice. And there Swamiji emphasizes on Pancha Maha Yajna. And then when you realize how blessed you are, you make every action as an offering. And then when you do Karma Yoga, very subconsciously, there is an inner purification of your mind. Of all mantras. The mantra means mananat trayate iti mantra. That when you reflect on it, brings about protection. And of all the mantras, you have one wonderful mantra which Dr. Sachin will explain to us. Sachin, over to you, please.
Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om, everyone. The mantra Om Asatoma Sadgamaya is taken from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. It is one of the most simplest mantra to chant, yet very powerful mantra. The literal translation is Om Asatoma Sadgamaya means from the untruth to the truth. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya means take me from the darkness to the light. Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya means from the death to immortality. To dive a little deeper into this mantra, one has to understand what does the Tat part mean. Tat is nothing but the Tat part of Brahman, the original consciousness, which is within all of us. The higher self, the entire study of Vedanta, which we are doing, all the seekers, want to get to the paroksha, the aparoksha part, that is the higher self. So the next slide, please, sir. So we are all always in this body-mind complex. We are always born to this body and mind. And that's why we are born to the lower order of reality, when we should actually dwell in the higher order of reality, that is the Brahman. Why does it really happen? The unreal part is because we are always in this Maya Jagat. Every sense of pleasure which we are seeking, it is always away, taking away from the higher self. Like you can see, all the sense pleasure are always outwards. And with all the desires, we are lurking around this darkness, the Andhakara. So the next slide, the meaning of Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. This Andhakara or the bondages are only because we are ignorant. Ignorant of the basic fact that God doesn't lie outside. It is not in this or that. It is within us. And how does the one get out of this ignorance? It's very simple. You have to know your higher self by studies, the knowledge. Once the knowledge comes, the light brings into your mind the entire Vedanta teachings, which we are so systematically doing, always with the help of a guru, an able guru. You will go from Tamasoma to Jyotirgamaya. And the last line, which says, Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. Now, we all are fearful of death. The recent corona pandemic has brought all of us to the understanding that everything is okay if I am okay. So, Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. So, from the fear of what? The death to the freedom. Here, we also have to understand, like, you have to die before the real death. So the first death is the death of your ego. And then the next death is like living this all body mind complex, the stula sharira, and immersing yourself into the vast ocean of the real self, the truth. The next slide is like a salt doll, which slowly immerses itself into the vast ocean and understands that it was nothing but the part of this vast ocean. So, coming to the concluding slide, which says that this mantra is nothing but the short form of Sat Chit Ananda. And as we have seen, Asatoma Sat Tamaya means the Sat part of Brahman. Then Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya is Chit part of Brahman. And Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya means Ananda. Hari Om, thank you.
Thank you very much, Sachin, for a nice explanation of this mantra. The very popular mantra, Asatoma Sadgamaya, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya. As you explained, this is from the Upanishads, the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. And all of us students of the Gita, next year we are planning a program soon after Sankranti about the introduction to the Upanishads. And you will have a flavor of the Upanishads, because Upanishads talk about these three things. What is Sat? What is that which is existent? What is Chit? What is consciousness? And what is our real nature, which is Ananta or limitlessness or Ananda? Next slide, please. And the next one, we will conclude our session with a story meditation. And I would like to share a little story, which is particularly meaningful for me. It's a story of a father and a son. And if you have to get the best of it, I want you to be the parent in this particular story. So the father and son were playing, and as they were into the game, the father gets a phone call by someone who says, "It is extremely urgent for me. Can you reset that message that I can't find?" And so the father has to get off from the game, but the little boy is not going to allow his father to do so. He wants him 100%. To make both things work, the father gives the boy a map of the world, tears it into three or four pieces and tells the little boy, "I have a little game for you, a jigsaw game for you. I want you to put the world in place. And I promise you, the moment you put the world in place, I will play with you." So the father goes to his laptop. The little boy was working on the jigsaw. And the story goes that in no time, the boy was able to put the whole world in place. And the father was amazed. He says, "Sonny, how did you do it?" And the boy says, "Papa, behind the picture of the world map you gave me was a picture of a man. I put the man together because I knew one thing for sure. If the man is okay, the world is okay." So this is the message, friends. If I am okay, my world is okay. We are gifted with a very organized body, but what is not organized is our mind. Our mind needs to be cultured. Our thoughts and emotions need to be cultured. Swamiji Chinmayanandaji is famous for his BMI slide. And this BMI chart shows the picture of Om, which is the highest a person can attain to. And before that, there is this big V. And what does this V signifies? All along, we have been talking about karmas that we have been doing over the years. Not only this life, in all our previous life, whenever we do certain actions, our actions produce a certain pattern, and these patterns become deep impressions on our mind, and that is called the vasanas. And unless we are able to work on the vasanas, we are not able to attain to something higher. Gautama Buddha had told us something about how to work on the mind. And the basic unit of the mind is our thoughts. He says, "Watch your thoughts because they become your words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become your habits. Watch your habits, they become your character. Watch your character, for it becomes your destiny." And he makes a landmark statement: if you're able to change your thoughts, we can change your destiny. That is where karma yoga as a useful sadhana helps us to work on the mind. The problem is with our mind. Our mind is, after all, an instrument, and it should be a tool that is available for us. But if it is not available for us when we need, if our mind starts dictating, because our mind constantly generates thoughts. And when our mind generates thoughts, I may be with you, but if there is a distracting thought, I am not 100% with you. I'm not in real time. I'm in my psychological time. And that is why karma yoga is such an important sadhana to be able to train our mind to be available for us. The Amrita Bindu Upanishad begins in a very remarkable way, which says, mana eva manushyanam karana bandha mokshaye. Mind is the cause of bondage. The same mind which can be trained and cultured through all these sadhanas can pave the way for freedom. I will conclude with another story, and this is a story when Alexander the Great visited India. He was very keen to see some of the realized masters. His soldiers found one person and he was refusing to come. Alexander had to personally come to this great saint and he requested him to come along with him. But the man said, no, I have everything that I need here. I am not going to come with you. The world conqueror that he was upset. He took out his sword and told the sage, either you are coming with me or I'm going to behead you. The man very coolly looks at him and says, you're welcome to behead me. But before you do so, I'd like to tell you something. You may think you're the world conqueror, but in my eyes, you are the slave of my slave. Looking at the charismatic man, Alexander cools down and asks him, what do you mean by the slave of my slave? And he says, anger and upset that you demonstrate are my slaves because I have mastery over my mind. And you are a slave to someone I have control over. And therefore, I consider you as the slave of my slave. And he finally concludes by saying, you might have conquered the whole world, Alexander, but if you have not conquered your mind, you have not conquered much. Next slide, please. And therefore, the message is, if you have mastered your mind, manjeet, Jagjit, and karma yoga can be a wonderful sadhana for us to be able to have victory over your mind, to be available for us to pave this path to moksha. We will conclude today's session by chanting the Stita Prajna portion, and this will be led by Mrs. Meenakshi and Mrs. Shamala Shetty. Over to you, Meenakshi and Shamala, for the chanting, please.
Hari Om. अर्जुन उवाच स्थितप्रज्ञस्य का भाषा समाधिस्थस्य केशव स्थितधि किं प्रभाषेत किमासीत व्रजेत किम्
श्री भगवान उवाच प्रजहाति यदा कामान् सर्वान् पार्थ मनोगतान् आत्मन्येवात्मना तुष्टः स्थितप्रज्ञस्तदोच्यते
दुःखेष्वनुद्विग्नमनाः सुखेषु विगतस्पृहः वीतरागभयक्रोधः स्थितधीर्मुनिरुच्यते
यः सर्वत्रानभिस्नेहः तत्तत् प्राप्य शुभाशुभम् नाभिनन्दति न द्वेष्टि तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता
यदा संहरते चायं कूर्मोऽङ्गानीव सर्वशः इन्द्रियाणीन्द्रियार्थेभ्यः तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता
विषया विनिवर्तन्ते निराहारस्य देहिनः रसवर्जं रसोऽप्यस्य परं दृष्ट्वा निवर्तते
यततो ह्यपि कौन्तेय पुरुषस्य विपश्चितः इन्द्रियाणि प्रमाथीनि हरन्ति प्रसभं मनः
तानि सर्वाणि संयम्य युक्त आसीत मत्परः वशे हि यस्येन्द्रियाणि तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता
ज्ञायतो विषयान् पुंसः सङ्गस्तेषूपजायते सङ्गात् सञ्जायते कामः कामात् क्रोधोऽभिजायते
क्रोधात् भवति सम्मोहः सम्मोहात् स्मृतिविभ्रमः स्मृतिभ्रंशात् बुद्धिनाशः बुद्धिनाशात् प्रणश्यति
रागद्वेषवियुक्तैस्तु विषयानिन्द्रियैश्चरन् आत्मवश्यैर्विधेयात्मा प्रसादमधिगच्छति
प्रसादे सर्वदुःखानां हानिरस्योपजायते प्रसन्नचेतसो ह्याशु बुद्धिपर्यवतिष्ठते
नास्ति बुद्धिरयुक्तस्य न चायुक्तस्य भावना न चाभावयतः शान्तिः अशान्तस्य कुतः सुखम्
इन्द्रियाणां हि चरतां यन्मनोनुविधीयते तदस्य हरति प्रज्ञां वायुर्नावमिवाम्भसि
तस्माद्यस्य महाबाहो निगृहीतानि सर्वशः इन्द्रियाणीन्द्रियार्थेभ्यः तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता
या निशा सर्वभूतानां तस्यां जागर्ति संयमी यस्यां जाग्रति भूतानि सा निशा पश्यतो मुनेः
आपूर्यमाणमचलप्रतिष्ठम् समुद्रमापः प्रविशन्ति यद्वत् तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी
विहाय कामान् यः सर्वान् पुमांश्चरति निःस्पृहः निर्ममो निरहङ्कारः स शान्तिमधिगच्छति
येषा ब्राह्मी स्थितिः पार्थ नैनां प्राप्य विमुह्यति स्थित्वास्यमन्तकालेऽपि ब्रह्मनिर्वाणमृच्छति
ॐ तत्सदिति श्रीमद्भगवद्गीतासु उपनिषत्सु ब्रह्मविद्यायां योगशास्त्रे श्रीकृष्णार्जुनसंवादे सांख्ययोगो नाम द्वितीयोऽध्यायः हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
थैंक यू श्यामला एंड मीनाक्षी फॉर अ वंडरफुल चैंटिंग थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स फॉर अ पेशेंट हियरिंग With this, we have come to the end of today's session. Coming Sunday to Monday, we will be having Deepavali festival. Wish you all a very happy Diwali in advance. Here, let us celebrate the festival in our own way with the light of knowledge as taught by Lord Krishna. There are no crackers to be burst that evening, that is on Monday the 16th, as there is a green Deepavali. So let's make ourselves free to listen to this Krishna Gita that evening. On that day, we will come out with more shlokas for study. Until then, let us do mananam of today's class. Let's meet on Monday evening, same time. Please log in before 6:45 p.m. local time. Let's conclude with Shanti Mantra. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ओम्